Several years since its foundation, the humble soil of Antipas has proven its dedication to strive for peace, excellence, and abundance, hence termed worthy as the economic center of Arakan Valley Complex. Antipas National High School, an institution born with the same desire, has flourished and is enthusiastic to continue its legacy. For years, worthwhile activities were laid out to strengthen the foundation of its learners, to prepare them in life, realize their dreams, and form in them the value of solidarity. Though times have been challenging, yet Antipas National High School remains steadfast in its endeavors and aspirations for a brighter tomorrow. That amidst COVID-19 perils, the true heart of the Department of Education triumphs as it continues to provide the same education to its valued learners. Learning sustained in a modular modality, the only feasible way for all learners to continue learning in the comfort of their homes. Modules have been delivered through our hardworking and committed teacher enablers. Despite this global unfortunate events, students and teachers embraced the new education system and continued learning as the entire school force was eager to deliver education and address the demands of a new world. With our sincere desire to deliver gratitude and fulfillment to our graduates in the previous year, a virtual graduation ceremony was carried through, which brought joy and smiles to our graduates in a distance.
Salamat sa lahat ng guro sa Antipas National High School na nagsikap at gumawa ng virtual graduation. Ito ay nagbigay ng kaligayahan, lalong-lalo na sa aming mga anak at sa mga magulang.
Hindi man po actual, pero yung saya at excitement ay karamdam pa rin po namin. Salamat po kasi pinaranas niyo sa amin kung gaano ka-fulfilling na ganap ng kilalanin bilang graduate.
We're bound with limitations. We are lucky to still be able to move and deliver change. With faith, it is our ardent desire that we can return to our normal lives. Learning, making friends, and chasing dreams. A delightful day to all of you. It is indeed a joyful moment to gather in celebration of our dear graduates in the Basic Education Department for school year 2020-2021. With this, I am greatly honored to welcome you all to this year's Antipas National High School Virtual Commencement Rites with the theme, Strengthening the Quality of Education Amid the COVID-19 Pandemic. As attested by all, we may have faced heavy difficulties and unfortunate occasions since the emergence of the COVID-19 pandemic. But I do believe, but no trial is insurmountable with you and with God. In the light of the present challenge, we have become the living witnesses to our patience, discipline, understanding, humility, and fervor in accomplishing our tasks. Hence, let us make today a mark of winning an invaluable battle. My friends, regardless of any obstacle, it is truly just that the hard work and achievement of our learners through the enduring support of this institution, the labors and sacrifice of our dear teachers, and the heartfelt cooperation of our loving parents and guardians should certainly be acknowledged and celebrated.
The processional.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the school's division superintendent, Izagani S. De La Cruz, CESO 5, the education program supervisor, Antipas Cluster Adopter, Edmond A. Rosete, the Antipas National High School Principal 3, Francisco R. Adenic Jr., Eliseo M. Soriga Jr., Assistant Principal for Senior High School, the Designated Assistant Principal for Curriculum, Ronnie L. Chiva, the Designated School Governance and Operations Division, Renato O. Oria, the Senior High School Coordinator, Dr. Lourdes J. Libuon. To commence today's ceremony, I humbly request everyone to stand for the singing of the Philippine National Anthem, which will be followed by a worship song prepared by Ms. Keisha Maylingaya and an opening prayer by Gerald A. Malayo.
Center, and everything revolves around you. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful day that we gather in this kind of platform to celebrate your goodness and the success that you have given upon us. We owe it all to you. We are thankful for our lives that at this moment, we enjoy the air that we breathe. And we are thankful for all the people behind this success, for our family who have cheered us and supported us from the very start and stood by our side until we have reached the finish line. For our friends and classmates and all the memories that we had shared together. For the school heads, teachers and staffs who loved us, taught us, and mold us to be a responsible person someday. We thank you for everything, God, that despite of this pandemic, we always experience your love and your grace. Lord God, we have nothing to offer except our praise and thanksgiving to you. And as we finally step to another journey of our lives, may you bless and guide us as we hold on to your promise that you prepared a bright future for us and continue to bless the school and all the persons behind it. May you fill our hearts with joy and gladness today as we give you all the glory, honor, and praises in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
This will be followed by the Panunumpa Sawat-Tawat, the Regional Hymn, Cotabato Division Hymn, and Antipas Hymn.
Panunumpa Sawat-Tawat ng Pilipinas. Ako ay Pilipino, buong katapatang nanunumpa sa watawat ng Pilipinas at sa bansang kanyang sinasagisag na may dangal, katarungan at kalayaan, na pinakikilos ng sambayanang makadiyos, makakalikasan, makatao at makabansa.
Lugo kami mula sa kawalan, binigyan mo ng buhay at karangalan, dati ay sinabukan ng iba't ibang dayuhan. Sabi mong lakas, hindi patatalo kaninuman. Mga Muslimo, mga Kristiyano, at mga iba pang tribo, kami nagkakaisa sa pagangat ng alam mo. Tugot na maniya, aray, pumailan lang sa pagkakay. Patuloy kang pinyapuri, kami sa'yo'y nawibili. Mabuhay ka rin.
To officially begin our program, let us now have our opening remarks.
Striving and winning is never a luck. It is yielded through hard work, perseverance, and strong will. Whatever inevitable circumstances this life brings, the choice of success is always within our grasp. To my dearest Antipas National High School family, stakeholders, to everyone who has been part of my victorious journey, I wish you all a fine day. When I was young, all I ever wanted was to just enjoy life with childish things. Even in my wishful thinking, it never crossed my mind to try to excel in certain field. But as I grew older, I began to reverse my choices and end up academically inclined. Not to mention my fondness in sport. With overwhelming support and tireless encouragement from my family, I had a change of heart and eagerly focused on my studies. This is the very reason why I landed this spot, your batch salutatorian. We might not be the luckiest to fully savor this moment because of this pandemic. I know in our hearts, we are filled with gratitude for we are able to take another step and open another chapter in our stories of success. Though we haven't seen each other face to face, isn't it amazing to realize that we still managed to hurdle up the finish? This alone will tell the world that we can make it on our own. We have struggled a lot. We were caught unprepared for the whole new setup. It seemed like we fought a war with nothing but weapons of patience and self-reliance. Yet, here we are, victorious and triumphant. This will be a long and bumpy road to travel. We are still at the crossroads trying to figure out what's ahead of us. No one can ever tell the journey that we are about to take. but we should always remember that success is a soul labor. We can rest, but we should not stop. We could always get better. As I move on, I want to thank all of you for being part of my Technicolor stories. So long, Batch 2021. All the best to everyone.
At this moment, we are going to witness the presentation of the candidates for graduation, to be followed by the acceptance and confirmation by our school's division superintendent, Mr. Isigani S. De La Cruz, CESO 5. Ladies and gentlemen, let us all welcome the Antipas National High School Principal 3 himself, Mr. Francisco R. Adenic Jr., for the presentation of the candidates for graduation.
Good day, everyone. To our Department of Education Secretary, Madam Leonor Magtulis Briones, represented by the Cotabato Schools Division Office Superintendent, Dr. Isagani Solomon De La Cruz, CESO 5. Sir, I have the honor to present to you the candidates for graduation of Antipas National High School, Poblacion Antipas, Cotabato, with the following breakdown. STEM, Science, Technology, Engineering, Mathematics, 16 male, 30 female, total of 46. HUMS, Humanities and Social Sciences, 80 male, 118 female, total 198. EBM, Accountancy, Business and Management, 2 male, 18 female, total 20. TBL, SMAW, Shielded Metal and Arc Welding, 29 male, 8 female, total 37. ICT, Information, Communication and Technology, 29 male, 16 female, a total of 45, with a grand total of 156 male, 190 female, grand total of 346. I further certify that they have satisfactorily completed the requirements of the K-12 set by the Department of Education and hereby to be confirmed as graduates of school year 2020-2021 and therefore have the privilege to receive their diplomas.
By virtue of the authority vested upon me as the school's division superintendent of the school's division of Cotabato, and on the basis of the certification of your school head that you have satisfactorily met the curriculum requirements prescribed by the Department of Education under the K-12 Basic Education Curriculum for Senior High School, I hereby confirm you as graduates of your school for the school year 2020-2021, effective today. You are now entitled to receive your diploma. Congratulations.
Friends, in every hard work awaits something worth working on and giving your best at. Awards may not only be a mark of excellence, but a motivation for chasing bigger accomplishments. At this juncture, we shall now have the distribution of diplomas and awards to our learners. Presenting the graduates of Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics Academic Strand of School Year 2020-2021 is Ms. Grace Lou Revilla.
I have the honor to present to you the graduates from STEMS Claren Caima this school year 2020-2021, composed of 16 male and 30 female, with a total of 46.
Balyo Alyo Jemery M, with honors. Kadungon Kimmer R. Kanoy Raven L, with honors. Katiban Aljun E, with honors. Combate John Rodel Davon, with honors, Gonzales Harold Angestrin, Gonzales Charwell John O, Agredante Jover John D, with honors, Malayo Gerald A, with honors, Navalta John Vincent Y, with honors, Delasor James T, Bengal J. Lord A, with honors, Lim Randolph Ivan C, with honors, Rocha Bong J. R. B, with honors, Simeon Rolly II C, with honors, Valdez Eljed Chris M, Agad Julie May O, Baro Vanessa May, with honors, Baliong Gemma A, with honors, Bautista Luella P, with honors, Kajau Arjun O, with honors, Kagang Jeneline A, with honors, Kandari Renaline A, with honors, Kanha Johanna Marie P, with honors, Kapote Nicole S, Pantanalgo Cyril A, with honors, Fernandez Elnor M, with honors, Frialis Erichen K, P, with honors, Helvolio Elias B, with honors, Gregorio Shaira C, with honors, Ising Abigail R, with honors, Haspie Roland Me, with honors, Libuon LJ Angel J, with honors, Lopez Diana Rose H, with honors, Magbanwa Josephine A, with honors, Mendigoria Jedidaya L, with honors, Octavio Chisca P, Osorio Aslin Nicole G, with honors, Palomo Yvette Joyce L, with honors, Tingal K A, with honors, Lenyago Majin N, with honors, Reyes Princess Marjorie M, with honors, Salamanca Angeline C, with honors, Sevillano Josie Felica C, Teas K Pamela F, with honors, Clarence Joy C, with honors.
Presenting the graduates of Accountancy and Business Management Academic Strand is Ms. Lovelyn B. Palomo.
I have the honor to present to you the graduates from ABM Equity this school year 2020-2021, composed of 2 male and 18 female, with a total of 20.
Espartero Christian, Ordaz David B, with honors, Antonio Carmela C, Arsenal Rose Jade B, Fajardo Reya Y, with high honors, Francisco Shane Z, Funes Generos O, Gauran Jerisit A, Jalama Cheryl E, Lagos Angelica T, Miguel Cristil Mayron D, with honors, Mondero Sofia Amor B, Nobleza Shindelkate M, with honors, Uton Angel A, Patombon Janeline S, with honors, Patriarca Rochelle Jean P, with honors, Piolio Rosalie A, with honors, Sabidalas Ina Grace L. Sapyo Jaya Cheryl C. with honors. Tingson Rosalina T.
And now, here are the graduates of our Humanities and Social Sciences academic strand to be presented by the respective advisors. First, we'll have Ronnie L. Chiva Maed for Erudite.
I have the honor to present to you the graduates of UMS 12 Erudite. This school year 2020-2021 composed of 18 males and 35 females with a total of 53. Congratulations!
Abasolo GRD. Abatay Mark Jeyo C. Alkisalas Ryan J. B. Balioalio Aljani A. Bantolo Roy Jones A. Kadungun Edsel P. Daven Noel C. Laios Prince A. Marcalencia Jamar Z. with honors. Montañez Roy L. Nikin Marlon G. Alma Joey C. Palmones Janmar P. Paron Rodin J. D. Petregosa Joshua P. Solano Jemuel B. Vallejos Alnar J. L. Yanson Glenn D. Agting Altea G. Aguilion Kristen May M. Alejo Sheena Alaisa A. with high honors. Amita Rija Jean D. Valoro Jovina J. with honors. Cacho Renalyn A. Canyabiral Joylin Mi C. with honors. Kari Jessel Jean C. Kasibwa Aisel A. Gabaw Nicole Ann N. Horigi Juliana A. Lamuna Cresa Joy L. Lingaya Kesha May B. with honors. Mayo Hazel Ann G. with honors. Mordisi Alexandra Mare S. Monies Winclair B. Ortigoza Emeline Joy B. Paklibar Lysel Jean P. Pagelio Rima S. with honors. Palmes Novian A. Pasqua Rona. Paulino Mayril M. Pedroso Jezabel E. Pintikase Janice P. Pero Colin T. Poras Glycel F. Poticar Princess Liza S. with honors. Roquero Rachel C. Sabanal Emery L. with honors. Samiliano Juname B. Suarez Edme O. Tabhan Chemelin L. Olod Lady Jane P. with honors. Valdestamon Maria Jessel A. Vicente Sheila Marie Q with honors.
Next, we will have Dr. Lourdes Jaylee Buon for Pioneer.
I have the honor to present to you the graduates from Humes 12 Pioneer for the school year 2020-2021, composed of 19 males and 31 females, for the total of 50. Congratulations!
Alamis Eric J.V. Aluhado Kier V.A. Bahinting Ralph A.J. Lu S. Banuelos Ryan E. Bautista John Lloyd L. Bailon Jude P. Boris Glenn F. Catulus Neil John M. Cloud Eugene Dale B. with honors. Kumbong Janbert J. Enzala Filking A. Gomez Jason A. Gravanto Neil C. Latido Jan Ivan C. Montenegro Mark Dale R. Navarro Elizalde Jan M. with honors. Nebrida J. Croy D. Polines Heldo M. Tumimbang Stephen James S. Abana Graham A. A. Andres Ledehart N. Antonio Rosmay Amor M. Atundukan Christina E. Bermudez Vanessa B. Bravo, Julie D. Cabrillas, Lori May A. Kadwada, Carol K. V. Cañaveral, Iris Joy C. Cañete, Mary Chris A. Cloud, Evelyn V. Egay, Sinele P. Isman Arian Claire P. Espanola Claire S. Galinata Gisame D. Hula Saraina Weed Honors. Lambating Muname A. Langote Jolene A. Margate Gusogin P. Nunay Sifanaya R. with honors. Pacheco Joyce A. with honors. Pasino Emily A. Padrillian Kyla B. Pansoy Lady Jean M. Pasqua Angeline P. with honors. Pulenes Honey Jean M. Rojo Alena Claire N. with honors. Somo Kizeya R. Venezuela Ina G. with honors. Villanueva Jisame B. Inyon Riami H. Congratulations.
Presenting the graduates for Section Gregarious is Winifreda C. Montales, Malt English.
I have the honor to present to you the graduates of Humes 12 Gregarious this school year 2020-2021, composed of 20 males and 29 females, with a total of 49. Congratulations!
Abelgas Prince Joshua C. Almiron Felix B. Almiron Raymar C. Amita Rojin D. Avenido Jubert, Caballero Alvin Lee B, Capilitan JP C, Develos Michael Angelo P, Ilikan Jerry A, Escudero Jr. L, Florita J. P, Yamba Romeo Jr. A, Gornis Gillian J. S, Lagunday Leo R, Latido Eric Jan C, Phil Others, Pagabalan Joshua B, Rabbi Ferdinand Jr. S, Tronco Jose Erwin M, Oyas Kenneth J. A, Vicino Janre B, Abelia Welfi N, Alison Jessica A, Amar Sandy Lee L, Antonio Jillian Grace T, Bantolo Charity O, Caligdong Crystal Joy, Kamiring Angel May T, Celestial Ella, Cordero Angelica, Diases Kyla Joy E, Duenas Diane T, Flores Jenilyn S, Fordan Jessel Jean V, Garpa Rebecca V, Guhiling Jessel Joy D, Lasaga Ariel Justin Lina P, Liris Kimberly H, Mandate Lorigin A, Mindigoya Desiree M, Paklaw Sheena N, Palma Angelica V, Pandes Missy B, Pedroso Nikki E, Piosca Jolimay J, Raposo Rhea May P, Regalado Nizel D, Rodriguez Leia S, Sulong Ashley Ren N, Sumagaysay Jessa G with honors.
Presenting the graduates for Magnus is Miss Cecil E. Libuon Maed.
I have the honor to present to you the graduates from UMS Magnus this school year 2020-2021, composed of 23 females and 23 males with a total of 46.
Amilador Elmer J. Q, Antonio I. P, Arvado Kristen Q, Kakundangan Eugene L, Camino Rene C, Castaneda Jonas G, Dulay Mark Louis A, Iridonia Janray M, Javier Ivan Philip M, Langote Alex Jr. Y with honors, Manalo James B, Matin Johnry Y, Montero Juan Jason C, Mutia Carl Ryan B, Namo Paul Lorenzo B. Niog Louis G. Noveloso Eric M. Remoroza Emmanuel T. Robles Ruel Jr. A. Salazar Jerickson M. Cedo Junel Jake N. Tubal Ayan Justin. Villanueva Julius Cesar Jr. T. Acting Mika May J. Apit Pizes Caitlin Giselle C. Balura Christine Nee F. Bayogos Reza T. Kahelo Giselle M. Canuto I. G. Katubo Ermary C. Dumot Rachelin B. Fernandez Syra Dorothy N. With honors. Nesuga Jemima R. With honors. Kilwa Marian Q. Himpayan Grizel May B. Iligan Ivy A. With honors. Haina Chrysaline Joy C. With honors. Lantaka Maria Teresa S. Magdamo Jericel III T. With honors. Matias Yula Chris M. Mendoza Giselle May G. Pama Janen G. Pintor Carmen Rizel C. Pio Renrose P. Tongkoa Cherry Faye S. Vasquez Bea V.
We now present to you the graduates from our Technical, Vocational, and Livelihood strand. Presenting the graduates of the Information and Communications Technology is Mr. Hernan De Los Santos.
I have the honor to present to you the graduates of ICT programmers this school year 2020-2021, composed of 29 males and 16 females with a total of 45. Congratulations!
Agno Bunimar A. Bayog Alduin Chris J. Bulanyo Ferdinand Jr. Y. Katingog Francis Jan A. Chiba Ryan Dave M. Kunihar Danmark M. Corbera Rini Jr. O. De La Cruz Spencer O. Diluso Jake C. Flores Jeffrey Jr. L.
Gabao Ray A.
Loxin Mark Judwick Fernand S. Mendoza Valentin J. S. Montales Anthony Jr. O. Montisor Edgardo J. D. Orbita Gilu B. Orbita Kyle B. Ordaz Eldin B. Palmis Jade Lawrence R. Ribuho Kinloid Y. Rinconada Russell R. Santerma Larry D. Silvidad Eric Jan S. Season Jan Denver D. Sulgan G. Mark A. Toledo Blorin A. Villis Junjirik D. Villanueva Marts Jan Anthony.
Apolinario Judith P. Chavez Princess Lorraine A. Gistro Jamil Gay Z. Hispaniola Shilami S. Dalarusa Shilami Q. Magsipok Angeline D. Niog Beverly May R. Ocharuna Angel Faith M. Ocharuna Julimi F. Padilla Rinalin P. Planta Crisil C. Pura Sikami B with honors. Salazar Shaina A. Salazar Shaira A. Sarbon Mia Crystal A. Yupalan Christine B.
Presenting the graduates of the Shielded Metal Arc Wielding is Mrs. Chenny Pelerico.
I have the honor to present to you the graduates of Shielded Metal Arc Wielding 12 welders this school year 2020-2021, composed of 29 males and 8 females with a total of 37. Congratulations!
Aaron Jefferson E. Alabado Franz D. Alamo John Paul G. De Guzman Joey L. Delicano Alden D. Enriquez Rick Jr. M. Espartero Jericho M. Estribor John Mark S. Fenis Norberto Jr. A. Folion John Mark S. Galvez Joren D. Gornes Gian Cedric S. Lagradante Edrivan D. Luzada Jericho P. Maido Romel P. Moranion Jeff Eric S. Naragdao Jomar D. Nietes Melvin O. Oberiano JRZ. Onduvilia Marvin N. Ongos Michael Ayan JR. Pajaro John Mark D. Panaligan Anthony P. Poras Mike Luis A. Sales Jason Ray M. Tongqua Benji O. Ventura Arthur Jr. R. Vihel Saldijan G. Yupalan J. B. Aguilar Karen D. Andea Jasmine Tiza Marie C. Angeles K. G. Arilia Cindy A. Ariliano Giovanni G. Bergante Lindy P. Pedroso Angelica A. Ponsalan Shira S.
Let us now have the awarding of medals and certificates.
Thank you.
With sincerity of happiness and pride, I am deeply privileged to have with us our top student for school year 2020-2021 for the Academic Excellence Address.
To our principal, Sir Francisco Aradenic Jr., honored guests and government officials, teachers and staff, dear parents, fellow graduates, friends, ladies and gentlemen, a pleasant day to all of us. It is an honor and humbling opportunity to be delivering the Academic Excellence Speech for our graduation. This year has been a challenging period to all of us. We experience unconventional learning modality through modular learning. This kind of learning scheme proved to be challenging to all of us. Honestly, I am quite sad because this would be our last year in this beloved and great institution. I have looked forward to doing academic requirements in school, hanging out with friends, bonding with classmates, and making memories that we would surely treasure as we course through life. Who would have thought that our last days together inside the campus would be March 13, 2020? It is very hard for us to adjust and fight the longing to be with friends and mentors in the old learning scheme within the walls of our campus during this pandemic, but we embrace the test of the situation. We never stop ourselves in learning, and we use this negative situation and turn it into an opportunity to spend most of our time with our family, focus on self-growth and rediscovering ourselves. For 6 years, the Antipas National High School has witnessed our growth, and it became our training and developing ground. I would like to share to you the 6 most important things I have learned in my high school journey that I am considering as my pillars and guiding principles. First, building a healthy mindset towards study. If we look into our schoolworks and we only see exhaustion out of it and then proceed to cling to procrastination, we can never be productive. Always remember, productivity starts with positive outlook, healthy mental state, and actions. Second, do not rush. Every one of us was so afraid and worried when we heard about the pandemic. Most of us questioned, what will be my future? Will my dreams still come true? And there we forget that we had only turned to the tendency to hurry. My fellow graduates, remember, we are on time. We are not delayed or late. We just have surpassed another mountain of struggles, and we are still on time. Let us not rush things, not rush your studies and our decisions. Take one step at a time. We can't reach the success by taking shortcuts. Just trust the process, just like what Hebrews chapter 6 verse 15 said, do not rush. Again, we are now in our special time, and this is our time. Third, rest and enjoy. When we are so tired doing schoolworks and we are very exhausted of hectic schedules, remember we have to take to rest. It is our reward and we definitely deserve it. There's nothing wrong in taking a break for a bit and reward ourselves for enjoyment. As the old saying goes, all work and study, no play will make the child dull. Fourth, do not pressure yourself. Honestly, this is my huge mistake in my junior years when I pressured myself on my studies because I thought my parents are pressuring me and have high expectations. But later on, I have discovered that I don't need to pressure myself because they did not even pressure me. It was just me in all those times who made myself worried and pressured. I set myself on fire. There, I have learned study should be taken serious but not under unnecessary pressures. Fifth, do not compete. I have read from a book related on business that said, you should choose the competition you will enter because you might choose the wrong one and no matter how hard you try, you may lose along the way. On the other hand, we must also be observant if there is really a competition that exists. According to my favorite author, Joanna Santiago, you don't need to compete. You don't have to struggle in a battle that doesn't exist. Let it go. Just keep your head straight on your target and forget about that competition thing. You will be the person you have dreamed today, no matter how struggle the process. Lastly, always be thankful. No matter how small or big the blessings we receive, always be thankful. At all times, be grateful to yourself, to your colleagues, family, and Almighty God. There is no more beautiful thing in this world than a heart that is always thankful. By being grateful, we are also humbled. This only comes if we realize that nothing that we have or achieve are our own doing. All our achievements, all that we have, are a summary of our parents' struggles and sacrifices, support of friends and people around, hard work and passion of our teachers, guidance of our alma mater, even of our mistakes and failures. Our very person and all that we have are all summary of God's mercy and providence. When we realize that reality, we cannot boast of anything, and it is only then that we remain humble and be truly thankful. That's why I'll take this opportunity to thank everyone behind this beautiful achievement in this season of my life. First of all, I would like to thank Antipas National High School for being my home and refuge, and the ground for my development and growth. Thank you for letting me develop and grow in this kind of school through the years. To our principal, Sir, thank you for leading this school and standing as the father of this institution. To my teachers from junior high school, thank you for your dedication in teaching and in giving life advices that I really found useful in my life, lessons that I remain to live by. To my senior high school teachers, especially Ma'am Lovelyn Palomo and Ma'am Christine Makiputin, thank you very much for helping us to gradually love accounting and learn it. To my other subject teachers in senior high school, thank you very much for your passionate service. I hope you will build and equip more students in these forthcoming years. To my friends and classmates, you are so many to mention, but thank you for moral support and advices whenever I have problems and for being there to share with my joys. To my family, Mamang, Papang, Kuya Balong, Kuya Nonoy, thank you for the unconditional love and unending support you have given to me. This success is all for you. Lastly, I thank our Almighty God for giving me this honor and all the guidance I need through this journey. In everything, glory to God in the highest. My dear fellow graduates, as we turn the page and close this chapter, we will be heading and facing another one. New chapters will be given to us, and may we all be equipped to face it. Maybe we are not standing on the same shoes, but take my 6 pieces of tips as a free advice. Remember those things as we take our separate ways en route for our desired future. Don't be discouraged and never doubt the ability of a willing person. I hope to see us soon wearing our best uniform in work or just the smile of contented and accomplished person. I congratulate all of us for the 2 years of hardship, laughter, tears and joy, and the success in this graduation. May we all be successful in our respectively chosen journeys. Have faith and strive. The world is ours to conquer. Let us make our families, loved ones, and our alma mater, Antipas National High School, proud. Let me end this with yet another word of gratitude. On behalf of our batch, salamat po sa lahat ng naniniwala, nagtiwala, nagmahal at sumuporta. Maraming 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 salamat po. Mabuhay and may God bless us all.
We'll now have Dr. Isagani S. De La Cruz, SESO 5, Schools Division Superintendent of Schools Division Office Cotabato, to deliver his message.
Isang mainit na pagbati ng tagumpay para sa lahat ng mga nangagsipagtapos sa taong panuruan 2020-2021. Ang aking mainit na pagbati ng isang mapagpalang araw sa mga magulang, mga guro, mga pinuno ng mga lokal na pamahalaan at lahat ng nakikilahok sa palatuntunan ito. Ako ay nagagalak dahil sa kabila ng mapaghamong panahon sa kasalukuyan, ay nagawa ninyong may pagpatuloy ang inyong adhikain upang linangin ang inyong kakayahan gamit ang iba't ibang kaparaanan ng pagkatuto. Tayong lahat ay nabigla sa di inaasahang pagbabago sa sistema ng edukasyon. Ngunit ako ay lubos na nagpapasalamat dahil sa nagawa nating makatugon sa hamon ng bagong normal. Lubos ang aking paghanga at auspusong pasasalamat sa mga magulang, mga pinuno ng barangay, munisipyo at probinsya, at mga samahang patuloy na nagbibigay ng tulong at tiwala. Kayo po ay naging kasangkapan sa pagpapanatili ng isang makabuluhang karanasan sa pag-aaral ng ating mga kabataan at sa pagbibigay ng matiwasay na kalagayan para matugunan ang kanilang mga pangangailangan. Sa ating mga kapitapitagang mga guro at masigasig na mga pinuno ng mga paaralan, ang mga pagpapakasakit na inyong pinagdaanan ay isang patunay na handang-handa ninyong ibinahagi ang lahat ng inyong makakaya para sa ikabubuti at ikatatagumpay ng ating mga mag-aaral. Kayo ay nagsilbing gabay ng ating mga mag-aaral upang mapagbuti nila at gamitin sa tamang paraan ang kagalingang bigay sa kanila ng ating Puong May Kapal. At sa ating mga magigiting na nangangasing pagtapos sa taong panuruan 2020-2021, ang aking pagsaludo sa inyong ipinamalas na pagpupunyagi at pagtitsiga. Patid kong kasama sa tagumpay na ito ay ang pangarap ninyong makapagpatuloy na makamit ang mas mataas na antas ng edukasyon. Ibig kong kayo ay paalalahanan na sa inyong patuloy na paglalakbay tungo sa tugatog ng inyong tagumpay, laging pakatandaan ang mga karanasang nagbigay sa inyo ng aral upang magkaroon ng lakas ng loob, katatagan, at sibuyon ng damdamin. Ang mga ito ay magsisilbing ilaw na magbibigay liwanag sa inyong tatahaking landas tungo sa hinaharap. Sa kabila ng tagumpay na ito, lagi sana kayong lumingon sa mga taong nakapagbigay ng inspirasyon at pag-asa tungo sa maaliwalas na landas ng buhay at sila'y handugan ng inyong di mapantayang pasasalamat. Tunay ngang ang temang kalidad na edukasyon, lalo pa tatagin sa gitna ng pandemya, ay isang kapahayagan ng pagkakaisa, pagtutulungan at pagdadamayan ng bawat individual, mag-aaral, mga guro, mga tagapamahala ng paaralan, mga magulang, mga lider ng lokal na pamahalaan at ang komunidad sa kabuuan na may dedikasyon tungo sa ikalalago ng kalidad na edukasyon sa probinsya ng Cotabato. Ating patuloy na isulong ang sama-samang pagbangon sa kabila ng kinakaharap nating hamon na dala ng pandemya. Kaya-kaya nating maabot ang ating minimithing mataas na antas ng pagkatuto at pagkamit ng kaalaman at kasanayang kakailanganin natin sa pagharap sa bagong normal na pamumuhay. Sa ating mga minamahal na nangangsipagtapos, kasabay ng inyong pagtanggap ng katibayan ng inyong pagtatapos, ay aking taimtim sa dalangin na nawa ay magiging tanda na magpapaalala sa mga pagpupursige, sakripisyo at kasibagang inyong natutunan sa kabila ng matinding hamon sa pag-aaral upang makamit ang inyong minimiti. Huwag ninyong hayaang kayo ay igupo ng mga pagsubok, bagkos gamitin niyo ito upang maging inspirasyon para sa inyong maliwanag na kinabukasan. Sa muli, isang mainit na pagbati ng katagumpayan sa inyong lahat. Pagpalain nawa kayo ng buong may kapal.
We will now have the message from the Regional Director, Carlito D. Rocafort, CESO 5.
Maalab na pagbati ang ipinaabot sa inyong lahat. Noong nakaraang taon, ang lahat ay nabigla sa pagkakaroon ng pandemya dulot ng COVID-19. Walang sino man ang nakapaghanda na mangyayari ito sa atin. Ang lahat ng bagay noon ay walang kasiguraduhan dahil sa pandemyang ito. Ngunit sa kabila ng lahat ng ito, ay nanatiling handa ang kagawaran ng edukasyon sa pagpapatupad ng Basic Education Learning Continuity Plan upang magpatuloy ang edukasyon sa gitna ng pandemya. Ito ay isang naging napakaabalang taon para sa ating mga guro sa paghahanda ng iba't ibang gagamiting kagamitang panturo at mga pamamaraan ng pagtuturo para sa ating kabataan. Naging mukhang bibig ng lahat ang distance learning na naging sentro sa pamamaraan upang maihatid ang edukasyon para sa ating mga kabataan. Sa mga ganitong pagkakataon, ang pagkakaroon ng mabuting pananaw at pagtutulungan ang siya lamang makakatulong upang malampasan natin ang pagsubok na ito. Kaya naman, ngayong araw na ito ay aking pinasasalamatan ang ating mga guro, mga pinuno ng paaralan, mga supervisor at mga assistant schools division superintendents, Schools Division Superintendents ng walong sangay dito sa DepEd Soccsargen sa patuloy na pagsisikap upang magawa ang kanilang mga tungkulin para sa pagpapatupad ng edukasyon in the new normal. Ang hindi matatawarang suporta ng mga stakeholders ang siyang nagpapalakas ng ating loob sa pagbibigay ng dekalidad na edukasyon para sa lahat. At ngayon ngang araw na ito, ay ating ipinagdiriwang ang pagtatapos ng mga batang naririto ngayon. Ito ay isa lamang patunay ng tagumpay ng kagawaran ng edukasyon sa patuloy na pagbibigay ng dekalidad na edukasyon sa pamumuno ng ating kalihim, Leonor Magtolis Briones. Sa mga bumubuo ng Class 2021, my warmest congratulations. Ang nakaraang taong panuruan ay nagbigay sa inyo ng kakaibang pagsubok at karanasan. Alam kong hindi ang ganitong klaseng pagtatapos ang inyong pinapangarap at ang inyong karanasang ito sa gitna ng pandemya ay nagbigay sa inyo ng kahandaan, ng katatagan sa pagharap sa mga hamon sa buhay. Hayaan ninyong ang ganitong uri ng pagtatapos ay maging inspirasyon ng bawat isa na sa gitna ng anumang krisis ay palaging mayroong mga tao na nakahandang tumulong sa inyo at maging daan para sa patuloy ninyong pagtatagumpay. Ngayong natapos na ninyo lahat ng academic requirements ay madideklara na kayong mga graduates ng inyong mga paaralan. Ito ay hindi lamang inyong tagumpay, kung hindi tagumpay din ang inyong paaralan, ng komunidad at ng buong sambayanan. Sa inyong patuloy na pag-abot ng inyong pangarap at tagumpay, kayo ay inaasahang patuloy na makikisa sa ating kagawaran, sa ating rehiyon ng Soccsargen, upang maipagpatuloy ang ating misyon na nakasaad sa tema ng ating pagdiriwang ngayong Graduation 2021 na kalidad ng edukasyon lalong patatagin sa gitna ng pandemya. Sa pamamagitan ng pagbabahagi ng inyong mga karanasan noong school year 2020-2021. Muli, maligayang pagbati sa inyong pagtatapos. Mabuhay kayong lahat. Mabuhay ang mga kabataang Pilipino. Congratulations everyone.
Ladies and gentlemen, let us listen to the message of Lenore Embriones, Secretary of the Department of Education.
Good day to each and everyone who is attending virtually present at this time of our graduation ceremonies for our beloved and very precious graduates for the school year which ends at this time. First of all, I'd like to greet the parents and family members without whose sacrifices, whose reminders, and whose participation in the learning process for our graduates have resulted in this culmination program. This year, your role has changed drastically, where we've always believed that the matter of educating our children rests nearly exclusively on our teachers and our staff. This time, you parents, you family members, you who are in the households of our learners, have expanded your role and contributed to this wonderful day, wherein finally, our learners are graduating in this culmination exercise. So congratulations, because this year has not been very easy, has not been a picnic for our teachers, for our family members, as well, especially the parents, mothers, fathers, sisters, brothers, and all who have contributed to the achievement of our learners at this time. So, maraming salamat at congratulations, parents and family members. Mas malaki ang role ninyo at this time compared to earlier graduation exercises. Secondly, I would also like to greet our teachers without whose very careful review and careful supervision of the work of our pupils and our learners, this event would not be taking place at all. And so thank you, teachers. Your role has also expanded. In addition to seeing to it that the modules are faithfully followed, the assignments are correctly implemented, and the learners are truly learning, and you have had to deal with new ways of assessing the performance also of the learners. So congratulations, teachers, for enduring, for your patience, for your love for our learners, and your willingness to engage in a way and methods of teaching which are different from those which are used to. Assessment must have been especially difficult for you, especially since you were not able to see most of the time our students in face-to-face meetings. And most of the meetings, of course, were virtual. We'd also like to thank the local government units for their interest, for their cooperation, and for their continuing contributions to the needs of education, even as our children do not go to school. Your donations of material as well as financial resources at this time are most welcome, and your advice has been taken seriously, not only by our teachers, by our school officials, but also by our officials in the Department of Education. We continually talk with local government units, especially in times of disaster, in times of great need for classrooms, for space, and for responses to unforeseen emergencies. Thank you, local government units. But of course, most of the congratulatory greetings fall on the deserving graduate. Each and every one of you is truly special. You are different from the other graduates who have passed through the portals of your school. You went to school practically without seeing your teachers, if at all. You went to school with your parents, your mothers, and your fathers hovering over your shoulders and seeing to it that you are able to complete your assignments. You are completing your studies at a time when examinations and assessments are different. You are culminating this long months of hard work at this time, even as you have to do family chores, even as you are distracted, and even as your world has turned upside down, and it seems and it appears as if we don't know what the future holds and what will happen next. But you have persevered, and now you are ready to graduate. And therefore, you deserve each and every bit of congratulations from us in the Department of Education, from your parents and family members, your teachers, from the officials in local government, as well as in the parent-teachers associations. You deserve each and every single congratulatory pat on your back, each hug virtually, of course, and each greeting, which I am sure you are also receiving virtually. I don't know if you will remember this event many, many years from now. I have tried to recall myself who our graduation speaker was when I finished high school and when I finished my college studies. All I remember is that the graduation speaker was someone important, someone who was invited because that someone is supposed to give a message. What was more important to us graduates at that time was the excitement of the celebrations, the happiness and the joy of our parents, the sadness of parting from our classmates and from our teachers, and the enjoyment of all the graduation events that usually take place come commencement day. When I was a college student, we had a series of events which were designed to embed in our minds, which were designed to help us remember and not forget our days in college. We would spend one whole day going around the campus, visiting the classrooms, saying goodbye to our teachers, and sharing memories. We would have bonfires to say goodbye to each other. We had baccalaureate services where we committed ourselves to God and we prayed for guidance when we go out into the world. So many celebrations, and the speaker, of course, is the least important and easily forgotten component of the graduation exercise. Nonetheless, I will exert all efforts to share with you what I see are things or issues which a graduate should remember and recall. I have said that you are very special. You are very different. You are pioneering. There has been no other class like your class. There has been no other graduate like you as a graduating student, because you are the very first graduate of the blended learning response to education in the Philippines. And so you ask yourself, what awaits you in the world outside? You can either work, because the kind of curriculum you survived and underwent as a student will enable you to go to work if you wish to go to work. Some of you will proceed to further studies, and this would be a wonderful thing because there are many opportunities for further expanding your knowledge, for further answering and looking for explanations of issues, events that make you curious, especially in science, in technology, and also in the arts. So you can work, you can go to further studies, and perhaps some of you will settle down, hopefully not too soon, so you can pursue what you really want to do. So today, this is why we call this exercise a commencement exercise. It's not the end of our studies. It's not the end of all our efforts with blended learning, with modules, with floods, with earthquakes, and of course, with COVID. It's a commencement of doors opening to you. More doors will be open because you are a graduate. You can work, you can proceed for further studies, you can help your parents, and you can perhaps look for opportunities to do what you have always wanted to do, whether at work, whether at advanced studies, whether at learning more in science and technology, in mathematics, and in the arts. All of these opportunities are available to you. More doors are being opened. I hope you will select the door which arouses your curiosity, the door which will help you know more about this world, and the door which will allow you to contribute to the development of our country and contribute whatever we can to solve our problems and our challenges. Congratulations once more to each and every one of you. Congratulations to you, parents and family members. Congratulations to you, teachers. When I was chair of the board of Silliman University, each time we had graduation ceremonies during the baccalaureate and during commencement itself, I would cry. I would cry because you are sending out into the world a new batch of graduates. And we want to be sure that what is awaiting them is appropriate. We want to be sure that they are ready for what awaits them when they select which door to open. And so, we tell you, go out to the world, do whatever you want to do. God be with you, and be assured that all of us love each and every one of you. Congratulations.
We'll now have the PTA's president, Edgar P. Caruda, to deliver his inspirational message.
Good morning po sa lahat. Sa mga minamahal kong mga graduates, alam ko na hindi madali para sa inyo ang nakalipas na taon sa inyong pag-aaral. Pero gusto ko kayong batiin ng isang mainit na congratulations and well wishes for the future. Your hard work and perseverance shall be applauded. And you shall be very proud of yourself for reaching this monumental accomplishment. For our parents and teachers, we are greatly indebted sa dedikasyon at suporta na ibinigay ninyo sa inyong mga estudyante at mga anak during this time of crisis. Truly, your efforts have come to a realization as we celebrate this momentous day. Sa pagsimula ng school year 2020-2021, at dahil sa dulot ng COVID-19 pandemic, sabi ng lahat, mahirap magklase na hindi face-to-face. Mahirap ang online. Mahirap ang modular system. Pero ito tayo ngayon. Let this virtual graduation ceremony be a reminder that we can overcome anything through concerted efforts. And we, the government, through the Department of Education, supporting you in every way possible. I know we'll be able to respond to every challenge, especially in the basic education sector. Sa inyong mag-aaral ng Antipas National Senior High School na magsisipag tapos, binabati ko kayong muli sa inyong matagumpay na pagtatapos. Kayo ang buhay na patunay na kayang magpatuloy ang edukasyon sa gitna ng pandemya. All the best para sa susunod na antas na inyong pag-aaral, anumang kurso ang kukunin ninyo. Patnubayan nawa kayo ng ating puong may kapal. Maraming salamat po.
At this juncture, let us now have the pledge of loyalty to the alma mater.
Raise your right hand and repeat after me. We, the graduating class of 2021, do solemnly swear to uphold the honor and dignity of our alma mater, Antipas National High School. We pledge faith and allegiance to the virtues and high principles to which we stand. We vow to exercise all the knowledge, skills, and abilities which we acquired over the years for the betterment of ourselves, for the welfare of our family, and for the service of our country. So, help us, God.
In this special occasion, the President of the Student Supreme Government, Nicole Osorio, will now pay tribute to our dear parents.
Adam Kay once said, "The greatest way to predict the future is to invent it. Our future is a lifetime mystery that we shall see." I urge you today to embrace the opportunity ahead of you. We should make use of what we learned on the last 12 years of study on something remarkable. in behalf of all the SSG officers and all graduating students of Antipas National High School school year 2020 and 2021, we would like to thank those people who are behind the success we are currently indulging. To our beloved teachers, we are really grateful to suck the milk of the unselfish guidance you provide. We appreciate your lifetime service in providing quality education for us students. We appreciate your unforgettable support, considerations, and sacrifices. To those teachers who pass away in the field of service, we will never forget the teachings and legacies you left in our hearts and our souls. As to our parents, thank you for providing all kinds of support and sacrifices you've made in order for us to reach our dreams. And lastly, to our principal, Mr. Francesco Aradenic Jr., thank you for being such a good and kind-hearted principal. We really appreciate your hard work and leadership in order to provide an innovative and a better place for us to study. To my co-graduates, this is it. We already reached the results of our hard works and perseverance. About to step into a fresh chapter of our lives. Hopefully, new achievements and new opportunities will welcome us in the future. Despite leaving our alma mater, we should always set into our minds that those people who are behind success, we are forever grateful to say that we, batch 2020-2021, are graduates of Antipas National High School.
The next part of the program is the singing of the graduation song by our graduates.
I know this world seems so big, and everything seems so out of reach. The sky is high and the walk is wide. You just don't know what you've got yet. It's in the palm of your hand. It's right in front of where you stand. If you believe everything you dream,
there's nothing I can be too big for you.
Let us welcome the assistant principal for senior high school, Eliseo M. Sariga, for his announcement.
My greetings to my beloved energetic principal, Mr. Francisco R. Adirik Jr., fellow teachers, both junior and seniors of Antipas National High Schools, PD officials headed by Honorable Edgar Carugda, my beloved parents, graduates, happy graduation, batch 2020-2021. Announcement, releasing of documents, card, diploma, good moral character will to be announced later. 2, Brigada Escuela. It will be done 1 month before the opening of the class. 3, tentative opening of classes will be on September 13 or 26, 2021. The following requirements for the incoming grade 7, grade 11, and transferee are the following. 1, card. 2, good moral character. 3, Brigada Escuela slip. For all students, you present your card and Brigada Escuela only. Good day, everyone.
Today, we say goodbye to school year 2020-2021. Time may be too fast and has somehow left scars in our hearts. But let us not forget that there are far, far better things ahead than any we leave behind. From our hearts, we celebrate with you as you move forward towards worthwhile undertakings and venturing humble beginnings. Congratulations, graduates! This is Psyche Joy Makapobre, your host for today's ceremony. We'll now have the recessional.
I can't remember when you weren't there, when I didn't care for anyone but you. I swear we've been through everything there is. Can't imagine anything we've missed. Can't imagine anything the two of us can't do. Through the years, you've never let me down. You've turned my life around. The sweetest days I've found with you. Through the years, I've never been afraid. I've loved the life we've made, and I'm so glad I stayed right here with you through the years. I can't remember what I used to do, who I trusted, who I listened to before. I swear you've taught me everything I know. Can't imagine needing someone so. But through the years it seems to me I need you more and more. Through the years, through all the good and bad, I know how much we had. I've always been so glad to be with you. As long as it's okay, I'll stay with you through the years. Through the years when everything went wrong, together we were strong. I know that I belong right here with you.
I've learned what life's about by loving you through the
only you. kinasaran na merong pikunan, lalo na rin ang unang niligawan, unang kabiguan, at dyan nasiseryoso ang usapan. Ang pagdadamayan ng tunay at tapat na kaibigan. Kung mga buwan kaibigan namang maaasahan, di na tayo mabata, edad may di nahahalata. Sa mga trip unti-unti na tayo back. Whoa, never gonna give up, no, please don't wake me now. 2, 3, 4.
Sinong crush mo sa room?
Ah, yung pangalan niya nagsisimula sa letter L.